بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is will be the last inshallah part in this book, and this part consists about four or five chapters. All its talks about judiciary in Islam. What do we mean by judiciary? This is, you know, something which is talk about the area of what? Of judging among people. Judging among people. And so it's called in Islam Al-Qadha. Al-Qadha. Qadha is judiciary. And when we talk about Al-Qadhi, this is the judge. The judge called Al-Qadhi. Qadhi. طيب شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمة الله عليه said, it is obligatory to assume the judiciary as a religious duty and as means of drawing near to Allah. Now why the Sheikh said this? Because some people, they may take this as means for what? For worldly benefits, you know, like getting more money, getting position, getting authority. And as we know that everything in Islam is based on the intention. So this one or the judge who work or he acquired this position just to increase his wealth or to all what he thought about is getting benefit, you know, in this world. And always what he cares, alaykum as-salam, all what he cares is about his own interest in this world, that mean, in fact, he may not be sincere in his duty. Therefore, the Sheikh said, the Muslim or the one who seek this position should make sure that to correct his intention should be for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. In fact, it is one of the best means of achieving nearness to Allah. Best thing, why? Because it is very important, sensitive position for the judge. The judge, he is the one who will set justice in the society and settle down disputes and problems between people. So this is something that he try, you know, help other people to live in peace together and get rid of any differences or any conflict. However, many persons in this position have been corrupted because of seeking leadership and wealth through it. So when the intention is not for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, then what will be the result? Corruption. Why? Because if he was seeking from his position as a judge to collect money, that means he will not be just, right? If somebody bribed him with money, then maybe he will give him the rights, huh? Even it's not his right. So this is why it is, if the judge corrupted, then what can you say about justice in this community, this society? Those people who have power or of money, they are the one who they will win their cases. And those needy or poor, even they have the right, they will not get what? Their rights. Now, so this is why the Sheikh said, Rahmatullah alayh, this is will be corrupted because of seeking, if it was the intention seeking, just seeking leadership or authority or seeking money in this world. طيب. Judiciary is legislated according to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and consensus of Muslim ulama or scholars. As we mentioned many times, these are the three sources for what? For legislation in Islam. Always. Any rules in Islam should be taken from the main two sources, Al-Quran and Sunnah. This is why the Sheikh started by saying it is already, you know, the rules for this was laid down in the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, and in the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu was salam. And then he mentioned the sins of the ulama, so nobody think it, there's any differences among the ulama. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, وَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَرَقَ اللَّهُ أو وَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ وَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ, which is the mean of this ayah, and judge O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam between them by what Allah has revealed. And from this we learn that the source of judgment among people is based on what? In what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Because Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who has the authority to legislate. No other authority. It's not to the people, like as you see maybe in some communities. It's not the people who decide what is right, what is wrong, or what is halal and haram. Naam? It should be based on evidences from the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi as-salatu was-salam. And this is what they call it, applying the Sharia. Applying the Sharia means applying the hukm of Allah, you know, the rules that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran or through the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jal said also, talk about Dawood alayhi salam. We said David, the meaning of the ayah, David, oh David, indeed we have made you a successor upon the earth. Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard. So judge between the people in truth. Fahkum baynahum bil adl, which means so judge between people with truth, that means with justice. This is in the Quran, Surah Sad. Right. Moreover, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself undertook the responsibility and appointed judges in the regions that were under the Islamic rule. The Prophet alayhi wa sallam always, when people have, during his lifetime, when people have any differences or any disputes, or always they turn to whom? To the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in any area which is far away from Medina, other cities, other regions, the Prophet alayhi salam will assign some of the Sahaba to take the responsibility of what? Of judging among people. Also, the Khulafa al-Rashideen, the Khulafa that succeeded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, took this rule. And furthermore, Muslim scholars agree on the necessity of assigned judge to settle dispute among people. So having judge, this is something which is one of the requirement of justice in any community. Because if there is nobody to judge between them, so everybody think that he has the right, and then will start the dispute, differences, and this will lead to troubles in the community. Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi said about the judge, the judge assumes the role of witness with regard to providing evidence. Assume the role of witness by providing evidence, because he is the one who check the evidence and then evaluate them, and then we will say, well, this will be considered as proof. Proof for the claim, if it was right or if it was wrong. The rule of the Mufti. Now what the Mufti do? Always. What's the rule of the Mufti? The Mufti is the one who giving fatwa, right? Now what does it mean, fatwa? Okay, what does it mean, fatwa? Right. The fatwa is to apply the rules which Allah Azza wa Jal revealed in the Quran or in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on certain situation. This is why we said, I go to ask about fatwa. Huh? No, asking about fatwa, that means you want to know what the Quran and the Sunnah say about this certain matter. Like for example, somebody say, come to you. And he said, if I travel to Europe, to Britain, for example, can I eat from the meat in the market? Now this person asking for what? For fatwa. What does it mean here, asking for fatwa? Asking, what can I do according to the Islamic rules, Sharia? So, the Mufti is the one who gives him the answer. How to apply the rules of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on certain case. Clear? Huh? Yeah, because you know why? Because sometimes, the Mufti give different answer. Look at this. For different people, which look for the people as it is the same case. It looks for the people that it is the same case. But you see, every situation, there are certain things which is distinguish this situation, huh, and different factors which is involved, huh, they involve. So the rule will be different, depend on the situation. Like for example, a person said, he swear by Allah that he will divorce his wife if he did this or that. Two people, they did the same thing. So one of them, he came, so the judge said to him, so this will be considered, will be accounted as one divorce. For the other one, maybe the Mufti will tell him, this is, you need to expiate for your oath, because this will be considered under, as oath. Both are, they did the same thing. So here the Mufti, when he gives the fatwa, he will dig inside, try to find out all the details. So he found that the first one, he was serious when he talked about his wife and swear that she is divorced, that he meant it. The other one, he just want to, you know, he didn't mean it, it was not his intention, but he want to stop his wife from doing certain thing. You get the point now? Is it clear? So the Mufti, or the fatwa here, so this is the judge, sometimes he plays the role of the Mufti. Why? Because in fact, what the judge is doing? Huh? He's telling the people, or apply the law of Allah Azza wa Jal, which is revealed in the Quran and the Sunnah, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, on this certain case. So sometimes he gives the right for one of the two parties based on what? On evidences that presented, and according to the Sharia, it showed that if he was, this was his right. طيب. Regarding issuing ruling, so when we talk about rules, the judge is like a Mufti. When we talk about evidence, huh, the judge will act as what? As witness. Right? Because any case that produced or you present to the court always include what? Huh? Two parties. One claim against the other, and witnesses or proof or evidences, and then to give them what? The judgment. طيب. And the rule of person and authority with regard to having judgment implemented. So the rule, in fact, according to this, the judge played how many rules now? Three rules. Three rules. Because he's a witness, because he's the one who verifies the evidences. Huh? And he is the Mufti because he's the applying the rule. I mean, show what's the rule based on the case that was presented to him. And among a person of authority in terms of what? Of implement the judgment. Because when the judge say this, then the other authority, they will apply, the police or, you know, other government agency, they will apply and they will enforce what the judge say. Right. In Islam, the judiciary is collective duty. Now, what does it mean, collective duty? What does it mean, collective? Nobody knows? Fardu kifaya. Fardu kifaya. What does it mean, fardu kifaya? We know, my dear brothers, al-fard, which is the obligatory, are either fardu ayn or fardu kifaya. Fardu ayn, that means it is must on in every single one if he met the required conditions. Like, for example, let me ask you this. Salah, is it fardu ayn or fardu kifaya? Salah, is it must on everyone or just few? Salah. Everyone, right? Yeah, so everyone, this is called fard ayn. Ayn. Tayyib. Tayyib. Naam. Salatul janazah, mathala. Fernal prayer. Is it must on everyone? That means whenever anybody die in the town, that the whole town go and pray? This is for kifaya. Zakah, for example. Is it fardu ayn on everybody? Yes, and if he met the conditions. But if it is not, if he has no money, then it's not Muslim. So the difference between fardu al-ayn and fardu al-kifaya, fardu al-ayn, which is required and it's must on every single Muslim. Clear, Abdul Aziz? Fardu kifaya, if a group of the Muslim, they did it, the rest of the community, they are not required to do it. But if none did it, everybody depends on the other, then the whole will be responsible for this task. Clear? So fardu kifaya, that the one who is able to do this task, he should do it, and when this group do it, this will be enough for the rest of the community. It's not must in everybody. طيب. So here judge, to be judge, is it must in every one of us to be judge? طيب. But is it must that there should be judge or not? There should be judge. Therefore, it is fardu kifaya. That means appointed certain people who meet certain criteria to carry the responsibility of judging among people. So it is fardu kifaya. طيب. As it is said, collective duty, as it is an in this respect, Imam Ahmad, whenever you say or you see Imam Ahmad, that means referring to whom? Who Ahmad? Which Ahmad? Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Always, whenever said Al Imam Ahmad, meaning Al Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. So sometimes they don't say Imam, like Imam al-Shafi'i always knows Imam al-Shafi'i, Malik. Imam Ahmad, some people, so this is Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. He said, there must be a judge among people so that rights are not lost. Right? Are not lost, because if there was nobody, as we said, who judged between people, then the one who have pride, maybe he cannot get his his right, it will be lost. Moreover, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has made it a duty to appoint one as leader when small group is on a journey. Such command goes for all kinds of assemblies. You know, in Islam, leadership is very important. This is why whenever there are group of Muslims together, they should assign one of them as a leader. Naam? And it's come in the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ, that group of three, they travel, then they should appoint one, or they choose one as a leader. Because if group are together, and there was not anyone that considered as reference or as a leader for them, and there's a problem or they want to take a decision, then to whom they will return. This is why it's very important to have a head of the group. Like for example, in a house, we know who's the head? Huh? The husband, right? The father. This is the leader. If you go on a journey, you choose one. Even when you go to Hajj, نعم, or anywhere, this is called Amir. يُؤَمَّرُ عَلَيْهِ. That means take as one as Amir. Amir means here, مُؤَمَّر, that means he's a leader. And it's very, very important. So the judge said, the Sheikh here, based on this, we know that it is must to appoint a judge in every community so he can solve the problems that face many people. طيب. If only one competent person exists who can undertake judgment, then it is an individual obligation upon him to do so. We said first that it is fardu kifaya. Fardu kifaya. It's collective duty. But in this community, none in this community meet the criteria except one person. He has the knowledge, huh? He has the, you know, knowledge of Islamic rules. He's the only one who fit this position. Then for him it's become what? Fardu ayn. It has become fardu ayn in this individual. That means this man or this person, he should carry out this responsibility. Because if he didn't, then will be nobody else who can take this position. Right? When appointing judges, the ruler of Muslims has to appoint judges according to the requests of the public interest, so the rights are not lost. Besides, the ruler has to select the best persons in terms of knowledge and piety. Knowledge and piety. Knowledge of what? Huh? Is it knowledge of physics and chemistry? Huh? Knowledge of the Sharia. Knowledge of the Sharia. That's mean of the rules, ahkam, which is in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Because he will judge among them based on what? On what Allah Azza wa Jalla said and what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said or did. طيب. If the ruler is not able to decide whether a certain person fits a position or not, he should inquire about him. So, if he knows the person, then we'll appoint him. But if he doesn't know, especially nowadays, you know, the ruler of the city, the capital, and so then they need to ask and search for the right person. Nowadays we don't need this because, as you know, in the modern state, they have a certain system, like, you know, ministries. Now we have Ministry of Justice, and there's minister, a person who is responsible about this, and he has his cabinet, he has, you know, his administration, who can check and find and choose. And also there's criteria, we have people who go and specialize in this major, al-qada. There are certain majors in schools and universities which prepare those judges. With regard to the He has to make every effort to establish justice among people. This is his duty. This is his duty. And he will be responsible and he will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about any judgment that he is doing. The judge is not obligated to observe what is beyond his capacity or be blamed for it. The judge is a human being. So his judgment will be based on what? On evidences, right or wrong. But if the one who has the right, he doesn't have the enough evidence to support his right. And then the judge, based on the evidence in front of him, he decides that he has no right. Will be the judge blamed here? Huh? Will not be blamed. Why? Because what he judging, in fact, depends on what? The evidence is that shown to him. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one time, he warned the people. I'm just telling you about the meaning. He said, the Prophet sallam, the meaning of what he said, that some of you, they come to me, and they are very fluent. They have fluent tongue. You know, they know how to present and talk their case. And maybe I give them the right of others. They take something which is not there. Because of what? Because they was very fluent and good in presenting the case. And the Prophet ﷺ, what he said, so if any of you, I gave him something which is not his, then in fact, I'm giving him a piece of fire. I'm giving him a piece of fire. That means he should be aware and should return to himself and think about, don't just depend that I gave it to him, it's become halal for him. Because when I judge it, you know, I give the judgment based on the evidence in front of me as a human being. You got the point? So if this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this, so how about others? Yeah? So the judge will not be blamed as long as he is giving judgment based on the evidences. But if he violates the evidences for his own desire or support one party motivated by his own desire, then he will be blamed and he will be responsible and will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. الشيخ أبو حذيفة معلي اليوم بدأنا متأخرين ها تذكرت أعطينا وقت شوي طيب and it is here when they assign a judge they should assign for him also allowance payment because if we said if you got you know hire somebody and you didn't give him allowance you know for money or salary how can he feed his children? How can he live? Huh? He was said, I cannot stay here. I have to go and search for work for my children. This is why here it is okay to give or assign salary for the judge because he's doing work. And he was hold this time, he saved it just to sit in the court and make judgment among people. Na'am? The judge's power are to be referred to covenant privilege in each separately, as I said in this area. طيب. As for the power of the ruler, they are not specified by legislation, rather they are depend on the customs of the convention. Here, another point, that sometimes the rules, the traditions of the community may play certain rules, you know, in some of the rules that which is applied in the court. And as I said, nowadays the Ministry of Justice has adopted a system to which judges stick. So these days, alhamdulillah, with the progress, as you see, in all Muslim community, it's become like a system, you know, even using this new technology, setting certain rules, everything is very, very clear and it's become easy. طيب. The necessary qualification that should be considered as much as possible for being an Islamic judge. Now, what are the qualification of judge in Islam? This is very, very important, because it's not chosen judge just because he graduated from the school of justice, or the school where they are teaching legislation. It's not enough because he graduated of this school or he has that major, but there are certain qualifications. First, to be legally accountable. For sure, will not put a judge as minor or insane, so he should be accountable. To be male, now this is very, very maybe strange point for you, because you see in many countries there are women judges. In Islam, only men can be judges, no women. No woman. And this doesn't mean undermine the role of woman. No. But the woman, they can do better job in other area. Better job in other area. But for judging between people, this is only for men. Subhanallah, same like Prophet and Messenger. Allah Azza wa Jalla never sent female messenger or female prophet. The highest position for female is Siddiqa, like Maryam, Maryam, the mother of Isa alayhi salam. وقال الله عز وجل, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about her, وَأُمُّهُ صَدِّيقَ, Siddiqa, that means she is saint, not prophet or messenger. So the same thing for judge, there's only men and men. And this is very understandable, because you see, here you want to judge between people. Women are mostly motivated by what? By their emotion. By their emotion. You know, and this one of the reasons. طيب. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the people who are ruled by women will never be successful. People ruled by women never be successful. So this, the general authority, the highest position, cannot be occupied by women. To be free men, to be a Muslim, for sure will not assign non-Muslim, because the judge should judge among people according to what? According to the Sharia, the Quran and the Sunnah, the Prophet, and should fear Allah Azza wa Jal. So how can, if he's not Muslim, you cannot meet this rule. طيب. To be upright, that is because it is impossible to appoint the definitely. That means adil. Upright, that means the person who is not known to commit many sins. نعم. A righteous person. To have sound hearing. Sound hearing, you talk about what? About the senses here, That he can hear, so he can hear what the people say when they argue in front of him. And also, he should have sound eyesight. That means he can see and he can. From this we know that it is not accepted to assign a deaf or blind person as judge. Because, my dear brothers, you know, judging between people is not only of the word that you hear. Sometimes a judge, or you can know the person when you look at what we call it, what? Body language. Right or not? Body language, sometimes expression that's come on the person through his movement, his the actions. So this is why he should have this qualification. طيب, the judge must have the faculty of speech. He can argue, he can ask, you know, and analyze what people say. The judge must be one who exercises ijtihad. Now, what does it mean, ijtihad here? Not jihad, ijtihad. طيب, ijtihad the one who strive to find out the right answer. That means he verify between different evidences. Like the mujtahid, like the alim, the mufti, who has different evidences. Different hadith. And then he went to conclude from this evidences certain rules. So he should look at these evidences, weight each and every one of them, and then he try to find what is the more reliable, the more strong evidence, and then he based his judgment based on this. So he should be a person who is able to analyze, to compare, and try to find the right decision based on the evidences that in front of him. We end with the saying of Imam Ibn Qayyim. He said, the one who exercise ijtihad is the one who possesses knowledge of the noble Quran. So this is the first thing. The one who won't be mujtahid, first of all, he should possess good knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In addition, the ijtihad of such person does not forbid him from adopting the opinion of other scholars in certain cases. That means if he found in this case there is similar case which was judged by other scholars, even from different madhab, and he found that, you know, fit this case, then there's no problem to adopt it and take it and depend on it to judge for this case. That is because one finds all the great scholars building their judgment on the opinions of those who are above them in knowledge with regard to some issue. So if you have knowledge, for sure there are some people or somebody who have more knowledge than you. وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفَوْقَ كُلِّ ذِي عِلْمٍ عَلِيمٍ And over everyone who has knowledge, there is somebody who has more has more knowledge. Therefore, there's no harm to consult some people and better knowledge or better experience. So here we stop here, inshallah. And inshallah, next week we'll talk about judge ethic. Jazakum Allah khair. Barakallah feekum. See you, inshallah, in next week. As I said, next week we'll meet at 10:15. طيب جزاك الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على سيدنا محمد.